The objective of this video is to spot the differences between the ventilation modes in an anesthesia device and an ICU ventilator. The first important clarification to make when using volume control ventilation or volume control outflow ventilation is because in most of the ICU mechanical ventilator, when we are setting the maximum limit of the alarm for the airway pressure, we are also limiting the maximum pressure built in the airways of the patient. In contrast, when using the anesthesia device, if we want to limit the pressure built in the airways of the patient, then we have to use the Pmax setting. If we want to just set in the limit of the triggering of the alarm, we have to go to the alarm configuration, and then we set the maximum level of the alarm for the pressure in the airways of the patient. Another important clarification to make comes with the use of the pressure support ventilation. When using pressure support ventilation and the patient is not sufficiently spontaneously breathing to meet the set minimum frequency, the device will additionally supply non-trigger breath to the patient. When the anesthesia device delivers this non-trigger breath to the patient, you will see the apnea alarm ventilation message on the display. In many anesthesia devices, the apnea ventilation alarm can be set to a low or a minimum level of severity. You can do that by going into the default configuration. To do so, please ask for the support of an experienced anesthesia colleague, or you can get in contact with your Dräger representative. Last important clarification to make is that, as in most of the anesthesia devices on the market, Dräger anesthesia device does not provide a dedicated apnea time or apnea backup ventilation mode, as you know, in the majority of the ICU mechanical ventilators. Another important clarification comes with the manual spontaneous mode. The manual spontaneous mode available on the anesthesia device is a unique feature that you will not have available on the majority of ICU mechanical ventilators. And this could be a life-saving in the case of a failure of the mechanical ventilation and the absence of the external manual breathing bag. To make use of the manual spontaneous mode, you have to totally understand the usage of the Apl valve. It is important to keep in mind that the Apl valve, it is disabled, meaning that it has no effect during mechanical ventilation. It is only during manual and spontaneous ventilation that it limits the maximum level of pressure in the airways of the patient. Even though the Apl valve is not actively functioning during mechanical ventilation, we have to understand that in the case of mechanical ventilation failure, the system will automatically switch to manual spontaneous breathing, meaning that even in this case, it is important always to set the appropriate level on the Apl valve. And the last consideration to take in mind is that during the self-test of the anesthesia device, the Apl valve has to be set to a very high level, meaning that after the self-test, the Apl maximum level should be adjusted to the specific patient. In the case the patient is spontaneously breathing, you can set the Apl valve to the S-pon position. Another important consideration is that the anesthesia device does not provide non-invasive ventilation mode. If non-invasive ventilation should be applied to the patient and there are no other options than an anesthesia device, special attention should be put to avoid leakages at the mask, not to fall into an insufficient fresh gas flow situation.